Hi, I am Ashwin Kumar Subramaniam Ganapati, a postdoc at the Department of Medicine, University of California, Irvine.
Hi, my name is Subrata Sabui, a postdoctoral fellow at University of California, Irvine. In this video, me and my colleague Ashwin are going to present how enterotoxigenic E. coli infection affect on intestinal vitamin C absorption.
Introduce the topic, ascorbic acid, which is commonly known as vitamin C, is an essential micronutrient which plays important role in cellular homeostasis. Humans cannot synthesize ascorbic acid on their own and hence must obtain from dietary sources. Intestinal absorption of ascorbic acid occurs via sodium-dependent vitamin C transporters SVCT1 and SVCT2. On the other hand, enterotoxigenic E. coli, referred as ETEC, has been reported to affect the absorptive and secretory functions of intestine. However, its effect on absorption of ascorbic acid has not been examined so far and hence is addressed in the present study.
We used two models over here. First one is an in vitro model of human intestinal epithelial Kakutu cells monolayer, and the second one is an in vivo glue knockout mice model. We also employed a variety of physiological and molecular biology approaches in our investigation.
Under in vitro conditions, confluent monolayers of Kakutu cells were treated with ETEC, boiled ETEC, ETEC supernatant, and boiled ETEC supernatant, and assessed for the vitamin C uptake. ETEC and ETEC supernatant inhibited the ascorbic acid uptake, whereas boiled ETEC and boiled ETEC supernatant did not affect the ascorbic acid uptake. This suggested us that the heat-level enterotoxin produced by ETEC could be responsible for the observed ascorbic acid uptake inhibition. This was confirmed using an LT mutant ETEC which failed to inhibit ascorbic acid uptake. The ascorbic acid uptake inhibition was also associated with a marked reduction in human SVCT1 and SVCT2 protein, mRNA and heteronuclear RNA. A significant inhibition of their corresponding promoters SLC23A1 and SLC23A2 confirmed that the LT-mediated inhibition is mediated at least in part by transcriptional repression.
To examine the effect of enterotoxigenic E. coli infection in vivo, we gavage glue knockout mice with enterotoxigenic E. coli and perform ascorbic acid uptake analysis after 24 hours. We found that exposure of mice to enterotoxigenic E. coli lead to inhibition in intestinal ascorbic acid uptake, and it was associated with the reduction in mouse SVCT1 and mouse SVCT2 protein, mRNA and heterogeneous nuclear RNA expression, similar what we have seen in vitro enterotoxigenic E. coli infection.
Heat-level enterotoxin has been reported to activate adenylate cyclase and increase cyclic AMP. In order to check if the increased cyclic AMP is responsible for the observed ascorbic acid uptake inhibition, Kakutu cells were treated with dideoxyadenosine, a cyclic AMP inhibitor, and assessed for their vitamin C uptake. No change in ascorbic acid uptake was observed upon treatment with dideoxyadenosine, further confirming the involvement of cyclic AMP. Downstream pathway of cyclic AMP follows either NF-kappa-B mediated pathway or protein kinase A pathway. To identify which pathway is involved in it, we individually inhibited NF-kappa-B pathway using celestrol and protein kinase A using H89. The NF-kappa-B mediated pathway inhibition did not affect the ascorbic acid uptake, further validating that it is involved in the ascorbic acid uptake inhibition.
In summary, these findings demonstrate that LT toxin produced by enterotoxigenic E. coli inhibits intestinal ascorbic acid uptake, and this effect is mediated, at least in part, via transcriptional repression of both the SLC23A1 and SLC23A2 genes via cyclic AMP-dependent NF-kappa-B mediated intercellular signaling pathway. Collectively, outcome of our study, at least in part, will help in designing effective strategies to optimize normal vitamin C body homeostasis, especially in condition associated with deficiency or suboptimal levels due to prolonged diarrheal illness upon enteric pathogen infection. Thank you for watching our video abstract.